Welcome back. So yeah, I know you've all been looking forward to this one. About a month ago, I had some time where my ISP had some problems and my internet connection was not entirely reliable. So I had an opportunity to try some of this game, and it looked really cool. It's been a month since I last touched this game. Chances are I don't remember any of it, so we're going to start a new game and see just if I can survive. Welcome! This game is designed to teach you the very basics of Japanese. Hiragana. You'll learn how to read and write all of the Hiragana characters during the course of your adventure. When your adventure is complete, you'll be able to move on to the more advanced Japanese studies. For now, let's begin. Okay. Sure. Sounds like a plan. I'll try not to spoil this for anybody. It's cold. But it's a beautiful evening. Claire, what are you doing out there? Get out of the snow. Eric, I'm heading to the tavern. Gotta get the chill out of my bones. I'll join you. Come on. Huh. It's lovely and warm in here. Much better than being buried in snow, right? You know how I am. I just can't resist admiring the night sky. You didn't change much this past few years, Claire. Neither of you, Eric. It's good to know I can always count on you to come looking for me. Yeah, let's have a drink. Cheers. Cheers. Oh, I forgot. I can use my controller for this game, I think. We'll see if that works. Hello. It's Leon. Mind if I join you for a drink? Leon? Weren't you kicked out of the village? Oh, yeah, it was a small misunderstanding. The elder thought that I stole his prized pumpkins. But I didn't. I didn't steal them. It's all behind us now. We had a good old laugh about it before. Not funny. But you baked pumpkin pie and gave it to everyone in the village. Exactly. That's baking, not stealing. It's good to be back. Oh boy. It's such a beautiful day. Clear skies, pure white snow all around. Simply wonderful. Since I have some errands, I'd better not tarry. Where should I go first? Excuse me, miss. May I have a moment? Stranger, I've never seen him before. Hello, sir. How can I help you?
Tell me something. You know, when I say blah 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 blah.
No. I didn't catch that.
That's too bad.
What's with this guy? What's this strange language he's speaking?
Farewell.
Magic? I can sense he's up to evil. I need to follow him.
Ha! It's too easy to conquer tiny nations like this. There's no resistance.
Stop.
Why?
You can't do this.
I don't see anybody trying to stop me. You couldn't stop me even if you tried.
Nah, I'll wipe that smug look off your face. More like, I'll get killed trying to... whatever this is. You're awfully brave, girl. However, you can't lay a finger on me. If you don't understand Japanese, you can't hope to dispel my magic. Japanese? Is that the language that people from Japan speak? He's talking about those weird word things? Let's see what you can do against my Hiragana warriors. I mean, what's so great about these warriors? But okay, fine. Ooh, that hurts. Oh, that also hurts. Ha! They're strong. What are these things? There's no way. I can't. Nope, we're gonna fight. Oh, I guess fighting's not an option. Oh, no, fighting's an option. Let's attack. Yeah, let's punch, I guess we're gonna punch Stranger Dude. Oh, yeah. Oh, he takes no damage. I'm getting beaten up by letters. Oh, well. Hey, at least I still got some... Oh.
Do you surrender?
See how your attacks have no effect on my Hiragana warriors. The only way you could ever defeat me is if you understood my language. But you will never learn Japanese. It's time to finish this. Bye. Oh, that's not cool. There's nobody else in my way. This village is as good as conquered. Although I didn't take down the letters that were over the inn. I'm pretty sure that sign is still hanging up over the kitchen there. Still, somehow, my Hiragana letters are... forget it. It's time to move on to the next helpless village. I can't believe he's so strong. You said to defeat him, I need to learn Japanese. Maybe I should order some sushi. Several weeks pass since the dreadful events in the village. Claire, our heroine, has spent countless hours helping rebuild the village. The mysterious Japanese mage left many of his Hiragana warriors roaming the lands around the village. Konnichiwa! Claire has come up with a plan to defeat them. Alright, today is the day we begin to fight back against the Hiragana warriors. I have spent a long time researching this Japanese language that we might need to learn to dispel the mage's magic power. Once we start learning the language, we can begin to defeat the Hiragana warriors that have invaded the land. I sent a letter to the capital asking for help with our challenge. The Great Library is sending one of their best scholars to aid us, along with some really good food and drink. Ah, it looks like she has just arrived. Hello. Hello, you must be Misaki. I'm Claire. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you, Claire. I've been informed about your situation. Thank you for coming to help us. You're very welcome. As you've probably heard, I am Japanese, just like the strange mage that caused the damage here. Scholar's name is Google Translate. That's funny. Please don't think we are similar. In truth, he's an evil magician named Noburo. My people have been trying to defeat him for generations. As you have gathered, the only way to destroy the Hiragana warriors he summons is using knowledge of the Japanese language. Starting today, I will be your Japanese teacher. Thank you. Please teach us everything you know. Gladly, first, let's head inside somewhere warm. Which is probably what we should have done from the beginning. I know you're all excited to meet me and everything, but consider that there's snow everywhere. When you're greeting someone, you don't want to greet them out in the middle of a big open plain when it's freezing outside. You want to greet them and give them a hot beverage and some food because they've been journeying, and have some consideration. Give them a chair. If necessary, let them use your facilities, your washroom. If they're exhausted, let them use your bed. Don't greet people out in the middle of an open field unless you're doing some sort of military ceremony. Just saying. Let's get started. Thank you all for volunteering to learn with Claire. No worries, I didn't want to see this Tom in trouble ever again. I'll learn Japanese and take down every one of the Hiragana warriors. Thanks, Eric. I knew I could count on you. You could count on me too. You know, I want to learn Japanese and travel to Japan in the future. Because apparently nobody in this town knows what Japanese is and thinks it's some sort of mysterious language. But now we're aware that there's a country called Japan. Good idea, Leon. Japan is an amazing place, full of beautiful scenery and wonderful people. And lovely ladies, I bet. Leon, keep focused. Sorry. Alright, attention please. First, I'm going to give you a rundown on what we'll be learning. Please pay attention. You want to make sure you have a notebook and a pen handy. Taking notes is the first step to success. That means you, player. Go get a pen and a notebook. I'll be waiting. Yeah, that won't stream well. So I'll do the best I can without a notebook. Now an introduction to the language. The Japanese language has a unique writing system made up of three different types of characters, known as hiragana, katakana, and kanji. Hiragana is the basic set of characters, and by using hiragana you can form almost any sentence in Japanese. We'll be focusing our efforts on hiragana during your adventure. The other two character sets are a bit different. Katakana is used exclusively to represent words from foreign languages. Kanji is a complex character set borrowed from Chinese picture symbols. It's quite advanced, but learning it's very rewarding. Back to hiragana. There are 46 basic hiragana characters, and each one is used to represent a unique sound or syllable. You can also make an additional 25 by adding small strokes to specific characters. And we will learn this as we go. So 46 and 25, for those doing math, is 71. Learning a new language can be daunting. If you begin to feel overwhelmed, take a break and come back with a refreshed mind. With persistence and bravery, you can learn all the hiragana. Remember to take lots of notes as we go. Revise your notes every day and soon you'll commit all the hiragana to memory. Alright, okay. Get your notebook and pen ready. We'll learn the first five characters right now. Go through them each individually and cover how to write and pronounce it. And then there's going to be a quiz, so pay attention. After the quiz, we'll travel outside to fight some hiragana warriors. The first five are short vowels. A-E-U-E-O. But these are pronounced as short vowels, not as long vowels. So it'd be like a, I, u, e, a, or something. We've written them above. Let's go through them one by one. It's the equivalent of the vowel A in English. It's pronounced a. It's a short vowel. All right. Yep, so we draw the one across, the one down, and around. It's kind of like a treble clef. And that's the A. One more time. Let's go across, we go down, and then we go around like that. Alright, now it's my turn. Here's some tips. The horizontal line is slightly curved. Should draw the character in three separate strokes. I can go down, right? Wait, how do I toggle through? Okay, we're gonna continue lesson. Get ready for the next character. E. It's the equivalent to the vowel I in English, but it's pronounced E. Not like the letter E, it's E.
E.
Anyway, it's a short vowel. Apparently there's a long vowel, I don't know. So you draw the left thing, and then you draw the right thing, and that's E. Again, draw the left side of that, and then the right side of that. Practice writing the character now. The first line is slightly longer. Both lines are slightly curved. The next character, U. It's pronounced U. U is a short vowel. It's interesting when they pronounce these things in Japanese, they have a very neutral tone. It's very, I don't know, I want to say flat. It's not like you're ascending in pitch or descending in pitch or anything. These are very simple vowels. These are short vowels. This is like a bass clef. So you draw the top stroke and then the bottom stroke. One more time. And that's U. The whole character is vertically long. Make sure you tilt the top stroke. The next character, eh. Yeah, I don't know how I'm going to remember this one. It's pronounced eh. It's the equivalent to the vowel E in English. Let's practice writing it. So you do the top stroke, and you go up and down and over. Yeah, maybe we can. Who knows? Do the top one. And then, I don't know, kind of looks kind of sort of like a lambda maybe, but not really. I don't know. Tilt the top stroke properly. The whole character should be made in just two strokes. The next character. Oh. Man, that is one confusing looking O. That's fancy though. Do this across, and then down and over. And then this little thing in the upper right. So you do across, down, around, and the upper right. And this is O. The vertical line is to the left of the character, not in the center. The vertical line is to the left. That means it's on the left section of the character, and this all reaches pretty far to the right and has this upper thing in the upper right. Okay. Yeah, we got the first five. All right, think of them as equivalents of A, I, U, E, O. All right, would you like to say progress? Sure, why not? Study Guide 1. Use this from the News Items menu to quickly revise this lesson. All right. Good. I think it seems like a lot to take in. Yes, I've given you quite a bit of information to remember. The best thing is to practice writing and saying the characters aloud. Be sure to get the pronunciation perfect, as it'll play a big part in forming Japanese words. Saki, you have a couple questions. Yeah, me too. I'm happy to answer your questions before we do a quiz. What do you want to know? Well, so far we've only learned 5 characters, but it doesn't look like I can make any Japanese words using these letters yet. What gives? Well, the letters we've learned are all vowels. In order to start making some Japanese words, you need to learn some consonants as well. You'll learn some next lesson. Zaki, I'm having trouble writing the characters out. They're way different from English letters. What do I do? Practice. Just keep practicing. The order of the strokes is probably the most important part of writing. Later on, you'll be able to review this lesson, so watch the animations once more and memorize the order of the strokes. Any more questions, guys?
All good, clear.
Thanks, Misaki. Great! Let's move on to our first quiz. I need to quiz you on what you've learned so far before I send you out to go fight. I want to make sure you're ready so you don't die, because that'd be kind of bad. Alright, here we go. What is this character? I think that was our first symbol. That was A. Correct. Well done. What is this character? That's the thing that kind of looks like a Z, but it's actually an E. It's pronounced eh. Alright, what is this character? I think this was U. Pretty sure this is U. Okay, cool. What is the character for the English vault? Oh. That was the one that had the mark in the upper right. But that's not going to help us later, because I've played this chapter 1 and part of chapter 2 before, and this game gets more confusing. Okay, for the vowel I, or E, it's the 2 strokes. Yeah! We'd completed the first quiz. Alright, let's get on the road. Let's challenge some Hiragana warriors in battle. Yep, yep, yep. One step at a time. Let's do this. Everybody, follow me to the village outskirts. Time to explore the world. To your characters, use the arrow keys. Forward, back, left, right, WASD. You can change things in the options menu. Oh, use escape to access the menu. That's a good thing to know. Yeah, I don't know. I think that just repetition helps a person learn anything. So, if the ordering... it's like a person learning a chess opening. Just having a particular sequence in mind and a pattern to the way you do things will help you learn new things. Alright, make sure you save the game before quitting, or you'll learn you lose your lesson progress. Which, let's be real, we're gonna be needing to learn things more than once. If you lose a battle, you'll have to reload from your last save point, so save often. Good luck. Don't die. At least don't die too badly. Alright, so I thought I had this working with the controller. Let's see, is that good? 80% is probably fine. Keyboard config. Let's see. Can we change? Yeah, I don't have one of those. Can I? Oh. I don't have a controller option for that. I thought this did support... Yeah, whatever. Finish configuration. Sure. Whatever. Good enough. Just exit out of that. Go back. Oh, good. I can sense Hiragana warriors nearby. How do you know it's not a natural forest? I mean, we're talking about a place that's never heard of Japan. Maybe they got... I don't know. But it looks pretty awful. Alright, everybody be on your guard. All right, we got three letters. We got an O, an U, and an A. Let's get them. All right. Eric attacks and messes up. Leon attacks. Yep. These guys haven't learned a damn thing. Oh. Alright. Oh! Hey, look at that. Oh. Never mind. I thought they were going to seize... Oh. Yeah, never mind. They did seize my guys. Sweet. Okay. Two of the Hiragana warriors fled, carrying Eric and Leon with them. Oh no. What do we do, Misaki? Stay calm, listen to my instructions, and we'll be able to take down this one. To defeat Hiragana warriors, we need to use our Japanese knowledge to hit them with a matching letter or character. For example, we're fighting against the character A right now. This means you need to hit it with the English equivalent character. That's the letter A, right? Yeah. So, select English, and yeah, okay, fine. If you get the right answer, you damage the enemy. If you get the wrong answer, they won't take damage. Alright, let's go. In battle, you take turns with the enemy to deal damage. You'll only damage by selecting the correct answers. However, the enemy can damage you much easier, so be careful. We got HP and MP. To restore HP, use healing items or support skills. If a character is knocked out, you can go return to town and stay at the inn to revive them and restore the health. MP is magic points. When you use support skills, your MP decrease. Restore MP with items or resting at the inn. Use the arrow keys to select commands during battle. And enter to confirm, cancel a command, or go back using escape. By selecting answer, you can attack enemies, select support to use support skills such as healing and cure. Okay. You'll learn more support as you level up, win battles to get money. Beats me why letters have money or characters have money, but whatever. Yep. Fight well! Alright, here we go. Let's fight. Let's answer. Yeah, let's attack this letter A using our English A. Oh, we can do that twice. So let's do it twice. Clear gives the answer A. Ah, attacks. Misaki gives A. Alright, do we win yet? Nope, we have to attack again. Nice. Oh, hey, look, we got it. Level up. Alright, we got... Well, I'm sorry, no level up, we just gain XP. Battle spoils, 78 monies. Probably yen, but what do I know? We did it! Alright, but Eric and Leon, they got captured by those Hiragana warriors. Let's go after them. They can't have gotten very far. No time to waste. Alright, let's just spend time talking first. They're a popular drink in Japan. Drink one of these Ramune. Ramune? Ramune? I'm not sure. To restore the health points. Don't be afraid to use it in a pinch. One of us falls in battle. Use one of these, revives. They'll bring us back to the fight and restore some hit points. Nice. You can use these and other items during battle, or you can use items in the field using escape. Save the game from the menu, etc, etc. Alright. Oops. Let's go back. How did I do on my keybind? Oh. Okay, cool. Okay, my controller bindings aren't what they need to be for me to use the controller, so I have to use WASD. WASD are not working either. Alright, we'll try the arrow keys to go left and right. Okay, that's cool. That's fairly obscure. Alright. We've got the letter E, or E, and then we've got Oh. So, let's fight. It's got... Wow, what's going on here? This is working earlier. Okay, we'll use the mouse, assuming I still have control with the mouse. Yeah, let's pick that one. And then we're gonna answer all for the other thing. Yeah, I'm not sure what's going haywire with my controls that's making this challenging. Alright. Yeah! We're gonna win this. Yep, that's right. That's also right. Let's see. Could have sworn. Yeah, I don't know. Don't know what I'm talking about. I gotta keep fighting. Alright. I still know what this letter is. I still remember what that letter is. Haven't drunk enough sake yet to forget all this. Man, that background track. Okay. Let's keep fighting. Sure. And, yep, pretty sure I know what that letter is. Taking notes and practicing. it depends what you enjoy, I suppose. Chess can be worth it, too. Oh, okay. Never mind, I have run on, so that's good. Ka-ching! Alright, we're attacked by... I think this is a letter A. So... Ah! Pretty sure it is the A, so we're gonna double down on that. So yeah, ah. And... Yeah, hopefully we win this battle pretty quickly, and we do. Nice. Alright, look at all that EXP that we're gaining. I wonder, can I navigate with the mouse? Oh, check that out. We can do this entirely from the mouse. Oh, okay, but hang on. Probably want to help this dude. What happened? You got your butt kicked, that's what happened. How embarrassing. You feel okay? Are you hurt? A little hurt. Leg is killing me. You know, just mostly my pride. For not having learned a damn thing from the lesson. We'll take it slow. Hang back now for now. Claire and I will take care of any foes we encounter. Alright, thanks for coming to find me. I owe you one. Don't mention it. Let's go. E appears. Alright, we're gonna fight you, E. We know what you are. Oh yeah! Who's the best? Not me, because I'm just starting to learn this, but, you know, I'm still doing pretty well at it. I think. Maybe. Huh? Where am I? You got captured by the Hiragana warriors. Luckily, we managed to find you. That's awkward. Are you okay? Are you injured? A little bruised, hurt my arm a bit. We'll take it slow. You hang back for now. Claire and I will take care of any foes we encounter. Alright. Thanks for rescuing me. No sweat. Let's go. Looks like everybody is okay. Thank goodness. There's only a few Hiragana warriors to clear out around here. We should head to the forest exit north of here and check out what enemies are beyond. Sounds like a plan. And we can school you dudes, who didn't apparently learn anything from that lesson, and just got beaten up by the warriors. So, yeah. Oh, that's intelligent pathfinding. Nice! It's more intelligent pathfinding than I expected from a game of this caliber. E appears. Alright. E, you're going down. Yeah. Claire gives the answer E. Just imagine. Eventually we're going to get to learn how to make real words with these letters. Or these characters. I have to keep remembering these are characters, not letters. Alright, let's keep going. Ah! We have been attacked. Alright. Let's keep going. This is gonna remember my waypoint. Nope. Apparently my character gets disoriented by battle. That's the forest exit up ahead. And we made it. There are much stronger Hiragana warriors outside the forest. It seems like we've taken care of the remaining warriors around here. What do we do now? We need to learn a bit more before we brave the dangers outside the forest. Let's chicken out, run back, regroup, and get ready for another study session. And hopefully, our two dudes are going to learn something this time. And you know, I can't wait to learn even more. Eh, sure, let's save. Why not? Yeah! Do you have your notebook and pen ready? We're going to learn our second set of Hiragana characters. We'll go through each one individually and teach you how to write and pronounce it. At the end of this chapter, we'll have a quiz, so do your best. Ka, ki, ku, ke, ko. It's like our first five letters, but now we have Ks that are pronounced. First five characters. We pronounce these syllables the same way, but we put a ka, a K in front. All right, here we go. These characters are very commonly used in Japanese, since each represents a syllable instead of a letter. You can form full Japanese words quite quickly. Here's our first new character. Ka. It's a consonant. Yeah. Pronounce this ka.
Ka.
Ka. So, okay, we draw a curve, and then slash through it. In the upper right. Huh. That's different than the ordering. No, this is similar. This is kind of like that ah we learned, where we drew the line across and then the vertical line. But this one we're doing across and down and then a vertical line. And then a mark to the upper right. So I guess it's similar to I in the way you write it. It's just you end up with a very different symbol. Make sure to put the third stroke in the right place. Let's get ready for our next character. Ki. This actually looks like a symbol you might see on a ki. At least if I remember my Dragon Ball references properly.
Ki.
A ki. So, one across, two across, slash through it, and then the bottom stroke. K. can be written in 3 or 4 strokes. The tail can be split into 2 strokes in some fonts. Use the animated example as best practice using 4 strokes. Next character. Ku. Ku. This doesn't look at all like U, if I remember right. This is Ku. I don't know why some of these symbols don't look very much like their counterparts. It's just one stroke. Alright. Okay. So, this kind of actually looks like E, but it's pronounced K. So, sure. Left stroke, cross, vertical stroke. Kind of looks like an H. Down, across, down. They all look different just to annoy foreigners and grade school children. Eh, who knows? Who knows?
Go.
I mean, they said these are the simplest set of symbols. If you really want to learn, like, kanji, that's more involved.
Go.
Alright. We got this. This is like E, but turned sideways. And that's cool. Okay, here we go. That's it. We finished this set of hiragana. These 5 characters. Ka, ki, ke. Damn it. I forgot what these are. Ka, ki, ke, ku. Cool. Sure. What if I told you we could learn another 5 within a few minutes? You would say I was crazy, right? Alright. First, would you like to save your progress? Why not? There's an amazing feature of the hiragana writing system called Datuken, or Tenten. Dakuten are little symbols that look like the above image. What are these used for? Well, when you add them to your hiragana character, you make an entirely new sound. So, this softens ka into ga. The G sound is always pronounced like a hard G. Don't pronounce it like a J. Okay.
Ga.
Ga. Nope. We're done. Alright. Gi.
Gi.
Nope. That's gi. Gu.
Gu.
Alright. Ge. So we got ga, gi, gu, ge, go.
Yeah.
All right.
Go.
Many hiragana characters can have dakuten attached to them, but not all of them. For example, you can't do this with a vowel, because if we could do this with a vowel, I would have told you already. Yeah, we got study guide 2. Oh yeah. Great lesson today. I hope you've taken a bit of information from this. Sure did, Misaki. This time I was actually paying attention, and I'm totally not going to die out in the battlefield this time. I learned way more than before. Again, because I was paying attention. I really like those dakuten marks. Who knew? It'd be so easy to turn one sound into another. If we count all the hiragana we now know, including ones with Dakuten, now we know 15. That's 15 different Japanese characters. Thanks, Misaki. So glad you're enjoying the lesson, but now it's quiz time! What's this character? I'm gonna say Ko? Yeah! What's this character? I think this is Ke? Yeah! What was this one? Gi? Yeah, so I have played through chapter 2 before, so I might recognize some of these. Ka would be his first one. Ge would be this one? Yep. Yeah, we completed this. Alright, let's head into town and relax. Visit the weapon shop. Might be able to purchase some new equipment for our next adventure. Alright. Well, apparently we gotta visit the weapon shop. Oh, that's the kitchen. Never mind. Just kidding. I know that totally looked like a weapon shop from over here. That's a statue. I was just hoping something would happen if I interacted with it, but nope. Alright. Sup, dude?
Welcome. Ever since dangerous hiragana warriors started roaming the land, I have set up shop in this village for weapons and armors. If you see anything you like, let me know.
Alright, let's buy stuff. What do you guys want? Should we buy tons of Ryune and completely neglect the fact that we should buy other stuff? Or... I don't know. There's a thing for Claire. There's a thing for Claire. I don't know. Some of these will help. Attack. Magic attack. For... Oh, this is for Misaki. Misaki would get some attack power from this. Heavy duty spike knuckles for... Yeah! Let's take that. Wait, what's this? Oh, this is plus 10, which is plus 5 over what Claire has. Whereas this is plus 8. Okay, I get it. I get it. Let's buy one of those. Yeah, I got 1234 monies. So, sure. Sounds good to me. Cancel. Yeah, we gotta equip stuff. Because the game doesn't equip things for us, because that would be too logical. Equip? Sure. Oops. Clear. Okay. Optimize. There we go. So. Yeah, that's the weapon shop. Now Claire can punch the heck out of everything. But you can also interact with the town folk. Oh, and your crew members. So much to do today. I'm still cleaning the mess from that magician a few weeks ago. Because apparently you didn't help clean with that for like a few weeks and rebuild everything. If you don't want to help me, then shoot. Okay, you're not helping. But okay, fine. What do you gotta say? My daughter keeps learning new words at school, but she doesn't apply herself long enough to learn the meaning. If I could relive my education and make sure I learn all I possibly could. But don't mind me, I'm just an old man. Yeah, whatever. This is my other party member, right? Hi, I'm waiting for Misaki to teach me. Let's run. Okay, fine. Guess we can't run away. Misaki's not trusting us to leave on our own. What should we do? Let's continue. Yeah, we're totally ready. Okay, let's go to the marsh next. Here we go. Snowleaf outskirts. Oh! Never mind, we didn't even get past the outskirts. And, Ooh appeared? I'm gonna say that's Ooh. Because that looks like an Ooh. Sure. Guard, guard, guard. I'm gonna see if I was right. Is this in fact Ooh? It wouldn't do for me to spend all my turns attacking and then figure out I had the wrong letter. Or character. Alright, that is Ooh. Oh! Oh! Claire evades the attack. Well done, Claire. Alright, we're gonna fight. That's an Ooh. Sure. Yep, still an Ooh. Definitely an Ooh. Totally, completely an Ooh. Alright, here we go. Oh. Well, now that I set up the attack, fine. Wait, why did my other party members start at level 2? All they did yesterday was pass out. I don't know, it seems like they're getting a lot of credit for not doing a lot of heavy lifting. I know they're my party members and all, so I shouldn't be envious, but... yeah. Alright, we got a couple letters attacking us. And that's an ah and an O, I want to say. So, yeah, we'll hit the first one, ah, hit it a couple times. The next one we'll say is O. And an O. And here we go. Oh man, we got some Japanese looking things in the chat here. Including some letters we haven't seen before. Which, that's pretty cool. Yeah, I don't know how I'm ever gonna learn how to string these characters together to make actual words. Given that I'm struggling with the character recognition. Character recognition has to be a lot, I don't know, saner for me to be able to put actual words together. Plus the font set is going to be different than any other font set I see. So we're going to the marsh. Caster Marsh. That's not the marsh. Wait. Oh. Okay. Let's go to the marsh. No, let's really go to the marsh this time. Wait, were we not going to the marsh? Were we going to the farm? Okay, let's head toward... yeah, whatever our destination was. Which I could have sworn was the marsh, but apparently isn't. Yeah, let's go to the town. Nope! Okay. Is our destination not the marsh? Well, you got me. Oh, hey, look. It's, okay. So this is the... okay, it makes sense, but this is the body of water. Oh, you probably could write Goku. Yeah. That's cool. This place is super boring. Alright, stay alert. We'll clear out the warriors as we go. You can dash by holding the shift key. Or if you went to the preferences or options menu, you could dash all the time. So, yeah. If somebody dies, go back to the inn, everything will be A-okay. Hey look, a treasure chest. You got a buckler. Wait, that's a weapon. Guys. Optimize? Yeah. I'm sorry, that's not a weapon, that's a something. Okay. Small shield that can be strapped to the arm, allowing full use of weapons is gone. Okay, so that's what a buckler is. I don't know why I thought that was a weapon. Alright. Encounter! Alright, so we got, Ku? And... key, I think. I don't know why the game bothered teaching me so many characters at once if it's not going to test me on all of them at the same time. Yeah, it does want me to build up confidence, but confidence is misguided. I don't know. So I can write kooky with these letters. Such useful Japanese. Alright, let's keep fighting. Yep, that's a key. It's still a key. We got still a coup over there. Alright. You know, I suppose that after ability to read katakana will come the ability to write it. But yeah, being able to parse even this more basic form of Japanese. Oh! Right, so Misaki had targeted the other character, which disappeared. Misaki still lashed out with the same attack against the remaining character, which is just wrong. Reflect and bless. Got learned. So that's cool. Maybe. I don't know. Oh no! Looks like the bridge is out. Guess what? I bet with some solid logs I could help build a bridge to get us across. Well, if you know how, I'll give you a hand. Alright, let's go find some logs. Where to look? Hey, look! Not foreshadowing anything, but there's definitely some trees and logs up that way. So, yeah, let's go plunder the chests on the right. Or the chest here. Got money! Alright, let's go back. Oh, we get the upper hand. I think this was call. We'll see if I got this right. And just guard a couple times. Yeah, I got it. I wonder if that's the same thing as, like, in the game of Go, where you have a call threat. I wonder if that would be written the same way. A weak healing spell. Sure. Why not? Answer... call. Answer... call. Guard. Although, I suppose that the idea of a cult threat would be something that would actually be originating from Korea. I'm sorry, not Korea. I mean, I know they do play Go in Japan and many other Eastern nations, but... actually, yeah, I think I am thinking of Korea. Hey, look, a treasure chest. Oh. That's some pretty pathetic pathfinding. Oh yeah, 1400 monies. Alright, so now we got some of the gi and ge and go and whatever. So this is actually ga? And this is gu? So, ga, there we are. Gu, be the other one. First one's still ga. Second one's still gu. It's not my turn yet, is it? Alright. So, again, the first... Yeah, this is Gaz, the one on the left. G is the one that looks like a mouth. And it's interesting, though, I don't think people, or Japanese people, would be using katakana on a daily basis. This would be for people who are more just learning Japanese and need more basic symbols, I would assume. I'm not sure. Oh yeah. Everybody's level 3 now. You got some battle spoils. Just keep buying more powerful weapons and beating the tar and stuffing out of these characters. Alright, so we got... I think this was Keth. This is Go. Kids today struggle with kanji. Effective educational motivation. Send children into the woods, I presume. Send children into the woods where they die if they forget their alphabet. Yeah. Well, survival of the fittest, right? They mix hiragana, katakana, and kanji to make it easier to identify where words begin and end. Okay, yeah, I've seen this, like, in some dubbed episodes. Occasionally there are usages of hiragana and or katakana to help clarify what kanji mean. If I remember right. I could be making some of that up, though. I'm not sure. Alright, let's just guard. Seems like only one of my characters has any hit points remaining. Alright. Might not be a bad idea to run at this point. I was gonna go grab the treasure chest and all that before running, but, you know, running seems a high priority at the moment. Alright, so there's Ge and Ko. Oh, we get the upper hand? Yeah, we're gonna run. That's the other thing about this game, is you can just run from just about anything. Alright, here we go to the inn. I suppose you're gonna want money. It's just 10 monies for one night. I assume that's yen. Again, I don't know. But yeah, let's stay. What if you don't have 10? Did your party just die? This seems like something I have to experiment with at some point. What if you can't afford the inn? And you're out of items, and you still haven't figured out what the words are. Oh man, that seems like a bad ending. Oh, never mind, we go up this way. There's nothing over to the left there. I still think this game could use some more advanced pathfinding. Like, if you can see something on the map, just do an A-star pathfind to it. But whatever. We got, Ge and Ko. So, this is Geth. This is Geth over here. This is Koh. And this is Koh. Nice, we got one character down. The sooner these my players level up, the better. Nice. Actually, since I went back to town, I probably should have picked up an item. Oh well. Alright, let's grab whatever's in the treasure chest. Ramune! Yeah, that reminds me, I do have healing items, which for some reason I am just refusing to use. Probably because it's boring. Alright, so we got... I think this is Ah. And... I think this is... Koh? So let's try this. I think this first one is Ah, I think this next one is Koh. We'll see just how mistaken we are. Alright, we need to figure out what this top letter is before it kicks all of our butts. I want to say it's one of these chapter 2 letters. It's got to be something in the category either starting with a G or a K. Maybe this was Ga. Oh, I'm sorry, yeah, Ka. Ga would be with the soft, with the whatever that word is. Yeah, this would be Ka. So this is the point of streaming the game, so we could cheat. And this down here is still Koh. This is still Koh. Yeah, cheating makes the game so much easier. So... I don't know if this battle theme is just overdoing it. Oh. No, that's wrong, Eric. Pay attention, Eric. We'll show you how it's done. Alright, let's guard, guard, guard. Oh yeah, guarding is so exciting. Why can't they all move in parallel? I mean, I know that would also suggest, like, the full ATB system where opponents are moving in parallel, too. Oh yeah, we leveled up. Got some money. Alright, let's grab some wood. Or a log. This is a good log. This is a bad log. This is an okay log. See, I think I should just be able to click over here on the right, and my character should navigate the entire path. Because I've already seen the whole path. They already know how to get there. But okay, fine. Alright, so we got Ga and G. So let's hit Ga with Ga. Let's hit G with G. Then you say goo and gaga and all that fun stuff. Oh yeah. Alright, see, Nicholas is now auto-hosting me. Cool. We're gonna teach everybody Japanese. Or I'm sorry, we're gonna teach them katakana. One character at a time. That is cool how your characters will guard before your other characters attack. Like, it seems that guarding speeds up your move. As it should. Because all you're doing is just holding the pose. Okay. Just keep going. Down here. Over across. Alright, we got a Gi and a Ki. This is a Gi. And we'll also start wailing on the Ki. The reason I have all my characters targeting the first symbol first... Oh. They attacked out of order. Or out of sequence. That's cool. Hey, Eric deserved it, because Eric gave the wrong answer. Because he's targeting the character that's no longer there. Alright, so Ki. As in, like, I think that thing that, martial arts people wear. It's called a Ki. Alright, let's go, go, go. There we go. Yeah! Look at all that EXP we're gaining. Alright, so soon enough we'll build this bridge. Ah. Man. Looks like we have enough logs to build a bridge. Let's work together. Phew! Great, thank you. Onward. Here we go. You sense a strong foe nearby. Who thinks it's Nobro? Place your bets. Alright, let's save, just in case it is. What is this place? This never used to be here. I wonder, could this be where the Hiragana warriors were summoned from? Must be right. What else to be here for? Maybe that Japanese magician guy likes the strange lawn art? Substitute the word mage for magician guy and you start to sound a lot smarter. But, okay, fine. I sense something powerful nearby. Maybe we should come back some other time. Nah, let's go. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Enemy shrine coming down. Nobro's Pierce. Ha! Sweet, you've come for another round of punishment. Yeah, we have. I mean, what can we do? This guy kicked our butt last time we fought him. Alright, let's do this. Everyone, listen carefully. Do not attack Nobro. Only attack the Hiragana warriors. For some reason, we're not strong enough to defeat him yet. But, you know, we can deplete his energy and, you know, traditional story arc sort of stuff. Alright, so we're gonna say, Ko is that top symbol. So just beat the heck out of Ko. And let's also start attacking, Ka, that bottom symbol. Nobro summoned a new ally. No, no, you didn't. Already got here. And it's just totally gonna kick our butt. I mean, why do you have such a complex symbol or character for such a simple? Oh. Okay, fine. We got, G here also. So, we're gonna fight Eh. I think the music is a bit gratuitous, but okay, fine. Yeah, I like the concept. Alright, we got a new... Oh, indeed, we've got a new ally here. Ha! Yeah, you can't attack Novgorod directly. Hiragana Heat! Alright, so then we got... Go! Here. Alright, and I don't know, I want to attack him directly. Some, yeah. Nobro's going down. I know the game told me not to attack him, but we're totally gonna kick it. Oh. Is he gonna run away? Coward. It's the same sound that was on Dueling Network. I can't say I'm familiar. Phew, he's gone. At least for now. That was exhausting. Mainly due to his language. But okay. At least you're able to deal with the Hiragana Warriors, right? You've definitely learned a lot so far. We'll get him next time. We should head back to town and rest for today. Tomorrow, we'll start learning the next set of Hiragana. Come talk to me in town when you're ready. Well, if that's not a logical breaking point, I don't know what is. But yeah, let's save our progress so far. And here we are back in Snowleaf once more. Preparing for Lesson 3. So yeah. I do intend to go through with the series and you know, maybe learn some more Hiragana. Honestly, I think probably next time I do this, I should probably start by reinforcing lessons 1 and 2. Not that I need to go through the whole game again. You could always talk to Misaki over here, and she's willing to reteach you the things that she already taught. So I think next time it'd probably be best if I refreshed all 15 characters I've already learned. And then went around town and purchased some equipment, armor, and so forth. And proceeded with Lesson 3. But I think it's probably going to get overwhelming and I probably won't retain things as well if I do everything in one session. So I think... after having completed these chapters, 1 and 2 is a good breaking point. Unfortunately for Mike. But yeah, Mike could have a chance to take a look at this video on demand and let me know what you think. Is this something that I should try to do during one of the, I don't know, during hours where people are able to watch it? Is this something I should reserve for, I don't know, other hours where I'm just doing things for fun and people probably won't be around? I'll have to figure out the right way to do this, because I do have some other games I want to play too. But yeah, I think we're learning some Japanese and some katakana, one character at a time. So you hate it when you're wrong and there's billions of characters character using people who are correct. You recall better the two characters that you learned the correct stroke order for. Yeah. It is challenging Like, I find it challenging that I basically am only learning the characters and have not seen them in a real context. So it seems harder to use those symbols in any kind of constructive way. I think I did briefly venture into Chapter 3, and then realized, you know, this would be a fun game to just do with an audience. But I think in Chapter 3, you start putting some of these katakana together to do more creative things. But this seems like a decent breaking point, so I'm gonna call this here. So yeah, thanks for watching. And hope you did enjoy learning Japanese to survive katakana battle. Or hiragana battle, of course. For educational Japanese resources, visit them online at studyjapanese.net with the hyphen between study and Japanese. Thanks for watching. Hope it was fun. If not, too bad, I'm still gonna do this. I just have to figure out, is this something that I should do with or without a large audience? Yeah, I'm sure once we get to later chapters, well, who knows? We'll see. We'll take it one step at a time. Right now, some of the letters almost killed us, or some of the characters almost killed us, so it's possible this game, I don't know, might be too difficult. There might be a better way to learn. But gosh darn it, isn't this a silly concept? I think it seems pretty well executed. I just don't know if it's a good concept or not. It's entertaining for sure. Anyhow, yeah, see you around. Take care.